Good morning and happy New Year 2023. Welcome to Dobbins Memorial United Methodist Church. I am Pastor Waleska Trinidad. Thank you so much for joining us for worship this morning. For more information about our church and support our ministry, go to our website, dobbinschurch.org. And let us start this amazing year with a word of prayer. Join me. God, creator of time and all there is, you have blessed us with another year. Help us to make room for the blessings that are in store for us in the coming months. May we be open to learning the right lessons, even if they challenge us. Help us to be open to the guidance of your Holy Spirit so we won't miss divine opportunities. Show us how to be grateful so that we can be a blessing to others. Please give us your peace as we pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thy is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Amen.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Are you ready to lose yourself and lose your weakness and find who you are in God's love and in God's strength? If you are, say amen.
Amen.
All right.
Jesus, Jesus in the morning, Jesus in the noontime. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus when the sun goes down. Praise Him, praise Him in the morning, praise Him in the noontime. Praise Him, praise Him. Praise Him when the sun goes down. Love Him, love Him in the morning, love Him in the noontime. Love Him, love Him when the sun goes down. Serve Him, serve Him in the morning, serve Him in the midnight. Serve Him, serve Him when the sun goes down. Thank Him, thank Him, thank Him in the morning, thank Him in the midnight. Thank Him, thank Him, thank Him when the sun goes down.
Jesus, Jesus in the morning, Jesus in the noontime. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus when the sun goes down. Amen.
Your faithfulness, O God. You wrestle with the sinner's heart. You lead us by still waters and to mercy. And nothing can keep us apart. So remember your people, remember your children, remember your promise, oh God. your love and justice, God. You use the weak to lead the strong. You lead us in the song of your salvation. And all your people sing along. So remember your people. Remember your children. Remember your promise, O God.
Not enough, and all the while
This morning is found in the Gospel of Luke, chapter 13, verses 31-33a. This is the word of God. At this time, some of the Pharisees came to Jesus and said to him, "Leave this place and go somewhere else. Herod wants to kill you." He replied, "Go tell that fox, I will keep on driving out demons and healing people today and tomorrow, and on the third day, I will reach my goal. In any case, I must press on today and tomorrow and the next day." Amen. Feliz Año Nuevo, Happy New Year 2023. Today is the beginning of a new year, and most of us are looking for a fresh start in some areas of our lives or a total transformation. And who doesn't want a fresh start or a clean slate, huh? A fresh start is a complete change in your ways of life or the way that you do things, especially after you have previously been unsuccessful. That's exactly what Jesus offered us. He gave us a new change every single day. When we say yes to God, new beginnings in our life, and we are called to go to new adventures that will require courage, perseverance, and boldness. We all hope and pray for a better year, a year full with health, countless blessings, and new opportunities. A new year to grow in a deeper and more meaningful way. A new year to strengthen our personal relationships and live life that bring honor and glory to our God. This year is the year that we want to make a real impact in our church, in our community, and in the world. Most of us have a list of resolutions for this new year, and we have a plan on how to achieve them. That it's key in order for us to keep pressing on and not to give up. We need to focus on our goals and be ready for the challenges to come. Because we know that sooner than later, we will encounter situations and even people that will get in the way of us and that resolution or that goal. In this passage, we see that Jesus was no stranger to this type of situations. Around chapter 9 in the Gospel of Luke, Jesus began his journey to Jerusalem, where he knows that he will face opposition and eventually death. Here we can see that there were some Pharisees who were not hostile to Jesus, or at least they seemed not to be, but they wanted him to play it safe. Like the other Pharisees and many of Jesus' own disciples, they did not get it. Even though their intentions may seem good, they are still resisting the new thing that Jesus is doing. They did not understand why he will risk danger to himself for the sake of his purpose. But Jesus' reply to them shows that he knew who he was. He was what he was going to do and the goal that he has at hand. He was moving forward, and the threats of Herod or the opinions of the Pharisees were not going to deter him. See, the words Jesus used in this passage are very powerful. I will keep on. I will reach my goal. I must press on. Having a goal in mind will help us focus on what you are aiming to achieve. When you do not have a goal, you will get easily distracted or discouraged. But Jesus pursues his goal regardless of the conflict or opposition. Despite the dangers, Jesus persisted even when it was not understood or accepted. Now, how often do we get distracted from the new thing that God is doing in our lives? For the new thing that God wants to do through us, sometimes by well-intended people, and sometimes even by ourselves. How many times do we let fear or others get in the way of what God has for us? And yes, you will have to study hard and sacrifice if you want to get accepted in that college. You will have to arrive early and leave late and put extra effort if you want to be considered for that promotion. And you will have to be intentional, compassionate, and empathetic if you want your marriage to work. You need to cut back on the expenses and be smart about financial matters if you want to get out of debt. You need to start eating healthy and exercising if you want to reach your health goal. No pain, no gain. Jesus was determined to finish what he started. So keep on, reach your goal, press on. Regardless of what areas of your life you're planning to work on, remember that apart from God, we can do anything. Our work doesn't have to come with stress, anxiety, doubt, worries, fears, or frustration. But through the power of the Holy Spirit, we can do it with hope, peace, joy, strength, because God is with us. We may not hit our goals right away, but this doesn't make you a failure. It means that we are just humans. We only fail if we give up. When it comes to spiritual goals, this is more important than ever. It is those times when you don't want to go to church, when you don't feel like doing the devotions, when you don't want to forgive the other person, and when you don't want to pray, that is when we need to press on our faith. Jesus knew and understood what his goal and mission was. In Luke chapter 4, verses 18, 19, Jesus is clear about it. And he said, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to bring good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim release to the captives and to recover the sight of the blind, to let the oppressed go free, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor." Jesus was determined to make it happen because there was too much at stake. We all depend on Jesus to accomplish his mission. Our lives and our salvations were on the line. Now, the question is, what is on the line for you? What is it so important that you accomplish your goals? What will happen if you let others to get on the way of God's calling and purpose for your life? Have you thought about the consequences of you not fulfilling those goals or that calling? That's why God is telling you today, keep on. Reach your goal press on. Jesus demonstrated the presence of God's kingdom in the world through the deliverance and the healing of people. And we can do that too through our testimony and our service to God. Just as there may be people and situations against you, God is for you. When God offers a fresh start, God offers a vision as well as protection. God will give you the wisdom, the strength, and empower you to succeed in whatever you do. You are God's beloved child. You are a child of God. God has called us for something greater, something bigger, something better. He has called us to live abundant lives. He has a special place for you and for me that start here and now. Whatever happened yesterday is in the past. Today is a new beginning with a new blessings available to you. Today is the day of a fresh start. Today, we're invited to partake in the banquet, the heavenly banquet that Jesus had prepared for us. This table, it's set as a symbol for us of a fresh start, where our sins were forgiven and our relationship with God was restored. Part of the goal and mission of Jesus was to die so you and I can live. On the night he gave himself for us, he took the bread, give thanks, give it to the disciples and said, take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. After the meal was over, Jesus took the cup, give thanks to God, give it to the disciples and said, drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant which is given for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this and remember me.
Everything behind me, and found the God who makes all things new. I look to you, drowning in my questions, and found the God who holds all wisdom. And I trusted you, stepped out on the ocean. You caught my hand among the waves, 'cause you're the God of all my days. Each step I take, you make a way, and I will give you all my praise. Seasons change, you stay the same, 'cause you're the God of all my days. I ran from you and wandered in shadows, and found the God who relentlessly pursues. I hid from you, haunted by my failure, and found the God whose grace still covers me. I fell on you when I was at my weakest, and found the God lifter of my head. And I've worshipped you and felt you right beside me. You're the reason that I sing, 'cause you're the God of all my days. Each step I take, you make the way, and I will give you all my praise. My seasons change, you stay the same, 'cause you're the God of all my days. In my worry, God, you are my stillness. In my searching, God, you are my answer. In my blindness, God, you are my vision. In my bondage, God, you are my freedom. In my weakness, God, you are my power. You're the reason that I sing, 'cause you're the God of all my days. Each step I take, you make a way, and I will give you all my praise. My seasons change, you stay. You're the God of all my days. Each step I take, you make a way, and I will give you all my praise. My seasons change, you stay the same. You're the God of all my days.
And now go with the blessing of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And the people of God say, Amen. Stay safe. Be blessed. Feliz Año Nuevo. Happy New Year.
Call out, don't let my feelings out, because of the love of Christ. I'm gonna sing and dance and shout, tell the world what it's about, because of the love. Gonna let all anger go, gonna let forgiveness grow, because of the love of Christ. I'm gonna tell everyone I know, the winds of grace are gonna blow, because of the love of Christ. Can't you hear his voice calling out to you? It reaches deep inside your heart. Just let the stone fall down and roll away. But Jesus, give your life a brand new start.
Because